My name is Laura, and I'm on the Chrome accessibility team at Google. In this video, I'm going to show you some ways to use your Chromebook with the ChromeVox screen reader and build on the material that you saw in our fundamentals video. If you haven't watched that video yet, we do recommend going through it first. Let's get started. In the previous video, I showed you how to use search plus the right arrow to navigate forward item by item on the page, and search plus the left arrow to go backward. This is what we call the object level, but you should know that you can also navigate by larger chunks or smaller details. You can navigate by large portions of the page, called groups. You can also navigate by line, word, or character. Let's check out how to navigate at these different levels. I'm going to start with the biggest chunk, the group. To navigate by group, I press search plus control plus down arrow.
Banner. Google Accessibility, skip to content, link.
To go backward by group, I press search plus control plus up.
Google Accessibility, visited, link.
Next, I'm going to drill down to smaller pieces of detail. I hold down the search key and press the down or up arrow to navigate line by line.
Google Access, skip, link, exited banner, products and features, explore some of Google product, heading to Accessibility Scanner. Accessibility Scanner can help Android app creators identify.
To navigate by single words, I hold down search, shift, and control, and press the right or left arrow keys.
Scanner. Can. Help. Can. Scanner.
To navigate by characters, I hold down search and shift, and press the right arrow keys.
C. A. N. November. N. E. Echo.
This is particularly useful when you want to see how something is spelled. Next, I'm going to show you how to move between multiple Chrome tabs in a given Chrome window. As I mentioned in the fundamentals video, certain keyboard commands, like the ones I'm about to show you, are not ChromeVox specific, but they are important Chromebook keyboard commands to know for efficient access, so I wanted to go over them with ChromeVox enabled. To open a new tab and then automatically jump to it, hold down Control and press T, as in tab.
New tab, tab, multi-select, selected, 6 of 7.
Notice that when I do this, my cursor is automatically in the address bar. To move forward between these open tabs, I hold down Control and press the Tab key.
Resources for developers and publishers, Google Chromebook keyboard shortcuts, Chromebook, use the built-in screen reader, Chromebook help.
To move in reverse, we add the Shift key to the mix. I hold Control and Shift and press Tab to cycle backward.
Chromebook keyboard shortcuts.
To jump to a specific open tab, I can use Control and a number, starting with 1.
Resources for developers and publishers, Google Accessibility, main, Y.
Chrome numbers tabs from left to right. So jumping to tab 3 would be Control plus 3.
Use the built-in screen reader, Chromebook help.
But if I want to get to the last tab, regardless of how many tabs I have open, I can press Control plus 9.
New tab, tab, multi-select, selected, 6 of 7.
I showed you how to use the address bar for searching in our previous video. But what if I want to find specific text on the current page? I can do this two ways. First, I can use the Chrome browser command, Control plus F, as in find, to open the find box, type my search text, and press Enter to jump through the matching results.
Find, edit text, window. Chrome browser, go to Chrome browser product site, link, heading 3, main. The Chrome browser supports use TalkBack to Chrome low vision features, Chrome keyboard shortcuts, link, list item, list, with 8 items, main.
If the match is a link that I want to click, I press escape to close the find and page box, and then enter to open it in my current tab.
Products and features, Google web view, Chrome keyboard shortcuts, Chrome help.
This method works with or without ChromeVox. Alternatively, I can use the ChromeVox find and page functionality by pressing search plus forward slash. This opens a search field in the ChromeVox panel.
ChromeVox panel, find and page, edit text, search entry.
Here, I type my search text and press the down arrow to jump through the matching results.
S-H-O-R-T. Chrome keyboard shortcuts, heading 1, article. Learn keyboard shortcuts and become a pro at using tab and window shortcuts, collapsed button, article.
The benefit of using this second method is that it searches through all text, including alt text. Next, I'm going to show you how to navigate tables with ChromeVox. I've opened an article in the Chromebook Help Center that I know has at least one table. In our previous video, I showed you how to use jump commands. I'm going to use one of them now. Search plus T to jump to the next table.
Open a new window, exited banner, row 1, column 1, table, 24 by 2, article.
To move forward, I can use search and the right arrow. ChromeVox automatically announces the current row and column so you know where you are.
Control, row 1, column 2, plus N. Open a new window in incognito mode, row 2, column 1.
But to get to the end of a row quickly, I can hold search, shift, alt, and control, and press the right arrow.
N, row 2, column 2.
I know that sounds like a lot of keys, but remember, you can always enable sticky mode, also covered in our fundamentals video, which removes the need to hold down the search key as the ChromeVox modifier key. As a quick refresher, to enable sticky mode, you double tap the search key.
Sticky mode enabled.
I'll leave this mode off for now though to show you the full commands.
Sticky mode disabled.
To get back to the beginning of the table, I hold search, shift, alt, and press the left arrow.
Open a new window, row 1, column 1.
I can jump to the end of the table by holding search, shift, and alt, and pressing the right arrow.
Right bracket, row 24, column 2.
Note that these ChromeVox shortcuts are specifically for navigating tables more efficiently. Of course, you can still use the different key combinations to move by object, line, word, or character. Now, let's explore how to get to different parts of the screen using your keyboard. For example, I press Alt-Shift-S to jump to the status tray in the lower right-hand corner of the screen.
LauraDemo, LauraAppDemo@gmail.com.
This menu has a lot of really useful items, like settings, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, user account information, and more. I can use the Tab key to move around.
Sign out. This device's accessibility button.
Press Enter to activate an option, or Escape to close the status tray menu.
Chrome keyboard shortcuts.
Next, let's talk about the lower left corner of the screen. The leftmost icon is the launcher, and I use it to access other apps or files. Just to the right of the launcher is the shelf, which contains icons for commonly used apps like Gmail and Google Calendar. First, let's open the launcher. I press Alt-Shift-L to place focus on the launcher.
Launcher, button, shelf, toolbar, window.
And then press Enter to open it.
Search or type URL, edit text, window.
Here, I can type a search by typing a term, search by voice, navigate through apps,
dialog, Google Calendar, button, Chrome Remote Desktop, button, files, button,
and even add new apps. To close the launcher, I press Escape.
Chrome keyboard shortcuts.
And again, press Control to temporarily silence speech at any time. Next, let's look at the shelf of app icons. You can customize this section to include your favorite apps for faster access. I use the same shortcut to get to the shelf. Alt-Shift-L.
Launcher, button, shelf, toolbar, window.
And then use the Tab or arrow keys to place focus on each app.
Gmail, button. Google Docs, button. Google Chrome, button.
Again, if I want to open it, press Enter.
Chrome keyboard.
Now, let's move focus to the Chrome toolbar. To do this, I press Alt-Shift-T as in toolbar.
Reload button, main, toolbar.
And then use search plus right arrow to navigate through the various items.
Home button, secure button, address and search bar, unselected, https://support.com.
To exit the toolbar, I press Escape and then Tab to shift my focus back into the page. Notice that many of these Chromebook shortcuts for getting around the different parts of the interface begin with Alt and Shift. I can use a similar one to get to the bookmarks bar. Alt-Shift-B, as in bookmarks.
Gmail button, bookmarks, toolbar.
From here, I can use the arrow keys to access my different bookmarks.
Chrome Web Store button, Google Accessibility button,
and press Enter if I want to navigate to one.
Google Accessibility.
Our team released additional videos about navigating Chromebooks by keyboard. These videos feature Chromebook keyboard shortcuts that are not specific to ChromeVox, but are definitely helpful to know for more efficient access. I'd recommend checking these videos out in the future. In this next section, I wanted to talk a bit about using refreshable Braille displays with your Chromebook. ChromeVox supports most USB Braille displays. As soon as you plug the display in, Chrome OS will automatically detect it and turn ChromeVox on if it wasn't already on. If you plug in your device and it doesn't seem to work, you may want to check your device's user manual or contact the manufacturer to make sure it's compatible. If your device isn't compatible for some reason, please do let our team know. I'll explain how to reach us at the end of this video. Based on your Chromebook's language setting, Chromebox tries to choose an appropriate Braille table for you. You can also use the Braille display keyboard to navigate through the Chromebook interface using jump commands. To navigate by heading, for example, I press the Braille keyboard's spacebar plus the letter H, dots 1, 2, and 5. Using the spacebar plus these dots is called a chord. To navigate backward by heading, add dot 7 to the chord. This is similar to adding shift to the command for the Chromebook keyboard. So, to navigate backward by heading, I hold space plus H, which is dots 1, 2, and 5, and then I add dot 7. The same command structure holds true for many other Chromebox jump commands. You can reference the full list of available Braille navigation commands in the Chromebox menus, as long as you have Braille captions enabled. Braille captions add the ability to see visual Braille output in the Chromebox panel. By default, this panel appears at the top of the Chromebook screen and displays written text that corresponds with whatever Chromebox is speaking aloud. You can also choose to show Braille captions in the panel, which show the corresponding Braille output. This tool is especially helpful for sighted teachers who want to visually follow along with what their student is reading on a refreshable Braille display. To enable Braille captions, I press Search plus A and then B, as in Access Braille.
Braille captions enabled.
The Chromebox panel displays what is currently shown on your Braille display, if connected, or up to 40 characters. When a given word doesn't fit on the Braille display, by default, it moves to the next line. If I want to change the way Braille is displayed, I need to open the Chromebox options. To do that, I press Search plus O and then O, as in Open Options.
Web Chromebox options, English, United States, menu item, 8 of 26.
Now I can navigate to the Braille section,
Braille, heading 2,
and choose how many rows and columns to display.
Change the current 6-dot Braille table by selecting an option from the list below.
I can also choose whether to display Braille next to the text captions or interleave them, meaning alternating text and Braille on the same side. In addition, this is where I can change the type of Braille, for example, from 6-dot to 8-dot or to a different grade.
Change English, switch to 6-dot, enable word wrap, check virtual Braille display, heading 2.
If I want to save any of those changes, all I do is close the tab with Control W.
Google Accessibility banner.
Some Chromebook models have touchscreens, and you can use basic touch navigation to explore with Chromebox. Similar to navigating on a mobile phone with a screen reader enabled, you can use one finger to swipe from left to right to navigate item by item.
Get started with accessibility scanner, visited. Go to Android OS product site, link. From hearing aid compatibility to a built-in screen reader, Android OS offers you a wide variety of tools for any kind of disability.
This is the touch equivalent of pressing search plus right arrow on the keyboard. To move backward, swipe from right to left.
Go to Android OS product site, link. Get started with accessibility scanner, visited, link, list item, list, with one item.
You can also use touch exploration to drag your finger around the screen and hear whatever's underneath it.
Chrome, change text, image, and change text, Chrome key, Chrome, high contrast Chrome extension, Chrome browse, Chrome browser, go to Chrome browser product site, link, visited.
As you explore, you will also hear the 3D positioning of the earcons. Touching a link somewhere on the left side of the screen will play the corresponding link earcon from the left speaker.
Chrome browser, go to Chrome, Android watch demo.
While touching a link on the right side of the screen will play the link earcon from the right speaker.
Chrome, change text, image, and change text, Chrome key, Chrome,
This combination of touch exploration and 3D earcon positioning can be especially useful if you want to get a sense for the physical layout of a page or app or of the Chromebook screen as a whole. To select and activate a given item, like a button or link, simply make sure that your focus is on the item and double tap the screen.
Go to Chrome for desktop.
One more thing. Chromebox adds a cool way to change the volume on your Chromebook. Swipe one finger up and down on the right side of the screen to adjust the level.
13, 33, 60%, 70, 40%, 24%.
Pretty cool, right? All right, this video covered quite a lot, but there's still even more to learn about Chromebox. Check out the Chromebook Help Center, as well as Chromebox.com, to find additional resources about how to get the most out of this screen reader. For general feedback or any questions on the topics you've seen today, go to groups.google.com and search for the public group Chromebox-discuss. If you join the group, then you can send emails to chromebox-discuss@googlegroups.com and participate in the conversation with our team and other users. You can also send feedback about any issues you're experiencing directly from your Chromebook. With Chromebox enabled, press Search plus A and then I as an Add Input, which will open up a feedback report, and then you can fill out the relevant details and submit. Also, look out for other videos on ways to make Chrome and Chromebooks easier to use. Again, I'm Laura, and on behalf of myself and the Chrome Accessibility team, thanks for watching. And don't forget, we have a handful of other videos about Chrome accessibility. Check them out here.